Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in. We are going to start a series of videos talking about ceramics, its structure and its applications as part of the material science class and also as part of the biomaterials class. So ceramics is a very important material in engineering and it has a lot of applications. In this video, we will talk about the history of ceramics, the basic things that we should share with everybody who wants to learn about ceramics and its properties and applications. So the word ceramic is driven from the Greek word which is keramos, and which means pottery. Keramos has its roots from the Sanskrit word, which means to burn. The Sanskrit language is an Indo-European language of India, in which Hindu scripts and classical Indian epics poems are written, and from which many northern India languages are derived, which they call it Indic. So it means to burn, right? So it's pottery and to burn. And the Greeks used to refer to pottery as things made from burnt earth. And you can tell from this history that we are dealing with material that we are collecting from earth and materials that we burn and to take, you know, specific form or shape and application. So we have the oldest ceramic, piece of ceramic that is known is called Venus of the Dolni Vestonice, and a picture of this is this one. So this is the picture of the Venus of Dolni Vestonice, and it goes back, it's in Czechoslovakia, and it goes back to, you know, 34,000, you know, BC, which is a long time ago. So this is really a cool piece of human heritage, let's put it this way. So this is the oldest time, you know, piece of ceramics that is known, and until 1950s or so, the most important uses were for ceramics are the traditional uses of clay, pottery, bricks, and, you know, glasses. Nowadays we have a lot of new applications for ceramics, and the modern uses of ceramics have been extended to include materials which are used in engineering to maximize, you know, structure, physical, electrical, or thermal properties, because the ceramics has different properties, we would like to utilize it in different applications that are useful for engineering, for a particular application and use. And we're going to talk more about this as we move forward. So the thing is that ceramics are used in structural engineering, to mechanical engineering, to biomedical engineering and medicine. So there's a lot of applications for ceramics because of their properties that we're going to learn about in this series of videos. To dig a little bit more into details about the definition of ceramics, the modern definition and the definition that everybody is using. So we go to the American Society for Testing and Materials, the ASTM, to see the definition, how they define ceramics, and to follow that definition. So ceramics are defined as an article having glazed or unglazed body of crystalline or partially crystalline structure. So metals are crystalline structures, and ceramics could be crystalline and could be partially crystalline. And that's the first distinction between metals and ceramics. We talked a lot about metals before, and now we are moving into ceramics. So, or it could be glass. And now, which body is produced from the constituencies of the ceramics are inorganic non-metallic substances. So it's not organic, it's inorganic material and also non-metal substances. And it could be formed from a molten mass, which solidifies on cooling, or it could be formed simultaneously or subsequently matured by action of heat, by heating it. So there's different ways of how we can create ceramics and how they can be formed. I hope this was useful in just getting ourselves to know what ceramics are and what's the definition and a little bit of history. Thank you for watching. Until next video. Bye-bye.